Okay, Mike Spion, everything appears to be fine dandy. Let's give her the usual text, which is this and that. There we go. I'll let friend on board. Hello.
Hello.
Hello all. Okay, we are back here for finishing Bionicle Heroes, I think, considering how fast we're going through it. So, let's finish it.
Do it the same way that last time. Mathematically, we finish it today, yeah?
In theory. Okay, let's just see. Okay, that looks correct.
Hey, we actually started it up, so we don't...
Yeah, no loud noise. I actually wised it up with this one.
Nice.
Yes, load. And I did tweak the volume just a little bit. Because, you know, game be loud. Alright, let's just pick up our money. And nothing there. Alright, so, what we got left? Done the green one, and we did those, and the red one. So, what do you want?
Let's go with the green one.
Green, okay. Not biased whatsoever?
Nope, not at all.
Right, here we go. Oh, look, it's the green Paraka.
Okay. Can you guess which power he has?
Acid?
Poison.
Close enough.
It's a little bit better because they had poison before.
I think you forgot to plug it in.
Test and it's coming off again. He dropped money, get it.
Well, apparently he dropped it right here, so I will be collecting it. Yeah, poison acid thing. I associate acid with green because that's how they do in media, but poison is a mixed color for that one. It either is green or purple.
Yeah, that's true. And poison is the thing where you have to be bitten, right? Because venomous is where if you eat it, you...
No, you mixed it up. It's the other way around.
Yeah. English language.
No, it's just that's just terminology. Maybe an English thing.
I'm not sure if we distinguish this in German. Or maybe just don't know the German word for it.
No, poison and venom are two completely different things. There is, you know... I don't think there is a language difference for that one. I mean, if there is, then okay. Fair enough. I'm feeling he's doing research right now.
Yeah.
So, are they two different things, or is there a difference?
Okay.
Easy. Yeah?
According to the translator used all the time, it's the same thing in German.
But they're two completely different things! Oh no. It's the one thing we English did right.
This is actually surprising because normally German is like the language is like...
For all variants.
Yeah, let's just make a new one for this or just string two words together to make a new one.
But for here, it's for something that should most certainly be separated. They're two completely different things. The language barrier would be weird.
Yeah. I actually think I'm going to look this up. Like, if maybe there's like a... medicinal term that this differentiates them, but like the common word is just the same.
Trying to think as to why is such a thing. I don't know, I'm assuming it's running the same logic as to why you have gender differences for objects.
I will tell you as soon as I find out why we have that.
Somebody tells me some random ass German scientist just couldn't be asked for that particular day. He's like, no, they're the same thing, it can't be asked to tell the difference.
Yeah, but some of those same people came up with the idea to just assign random genders to objects and change the grammar of making sentences with these, depending on that.
Well, someone had to decide all these words, and it must have been that one guy who just didn't want to follow the program.
It's always something where 3 or 7 people are like... Because, like, a lot of people that are not native German speakers are bad with that, because there's no logic to them, you just have to learn it by heart, so they're making fun of them for talking, but it's like, have you tried to learn this? Like, if you didn't learn it growing up, it makes no sense, of course people get it wrong.
Words, they be difficult. Yeah. Right, why won't this open? There must be a switch nearby that involves Hookie at some point. Ah, there it is. It's new juke, good enough.
Sniping. Actually, it wasn't even the right way.
No, it was an extra, because, you know, points.
Okay,
I saw a thing, and I wanted it.
That's bad.
This is actually weird.
More effective than killing your enemies.
It's weird that this game doesn't really refer to the heroes much by their names. I think they only refer to the shop, and that's it. So if you forget their names, tough.
But you don't need to know the names either, it's like...
Well, kinda. Also, I think the ice one is not Nuju. Nuju was for the, one of the previous ones.
I don't know, it's not the right version, but I kinda wanted to factor that it's not some of the names though.
It's Noparu, I think this one is. The names are weird. It doesn't help that, like, majority of, like, the first Toa names, like, majority of what the lore was naming on was based on an actual culture's, like, language. Like, if you ever wondered why the Matoran are sometimes referred to as the Tohunga, that was one of the, well... the people who actually had the name kind of realized that, hey, Lego's using our language. We should stop that.
Oh, God, so they got puppets because they just...
used the language. He's like, no one's gonna know what this language is. But they managed to dispute it, and the Tohunga had to be changed to Matoran. So that's probably why if you go to the online game, you might, or just anything from the first, you know, Chronicle stuff, you might find some remnants languages.
I didn't know this, but I mean, it's not that uncommon to, like, have it been in another language, like Latin or something, because...
Oh, that is common, because no one uses it.
Yeah, because no one uses it, and it's always nice, like, when people kind of, like, simulate plot points because they know, and it can be a cool tool for, like, foreshadowing.
Okay, how do we... what kind of wording should we use to, you know, create for, like, magic spells? I just use Latin, it's easier.
Pretty much, yeah.
What is this place? Like a water well thing? A dam? There's water flowing here. Where's the beavers?
Do they exist in Bionic Universe?
Must be some equivalent. Oh, okay. Missed him. There we go. Ah, that's it. Yep, in Barnacle, their animals are the, where was in my head and then it vanished? God damn it. The Rahi. There we go. That's what their animal variants are. It's just, that's what their animals are, the Rahi. But there's like a wide variety of them. It's like, they can't all be called Rahi.
There's no distinction, so it's the point because Mario is like the general term, like we use
like
as animals.
Some exceptions, but yeah, pretty much. That way. Of course, this is one of the rare gates you can't destroy.
I hope it is out of non Lego.
Yeah, the only thing you can't destroy are not made of Lego, and that one's not made of Lego. Even though there's a clear Lego piece right here.
And it's not Lego fight, so.
It hasn't got the Lego colors, it's not an official piece. Ooh. Let me think. Lego is known for, like, no longer using current colors for particular pieces. Like, Barnacle's a great example, really. If you may have noticed that the, this particular type of color for the Toa Earth of Rock, whatever it is, the orange one, it used to be just general brown, but they decided to deviate from it and went towards orange because they didn't use that brown color anymore because it wasn't exactly common to use. So it just made it orange instead. It's like, just gradually change it. Yeah, it was just an uncommon color.
Is this also that they started to like change the shades of like black, gray sometimes as well?
Yeah, similar thing, like the sake of cheapening material and such.
Is that because we were, I actually kind of stopped a bit with the same, like of rebuilding all our Lego sets so that we could split them apart and see how much is missing. And then in Billions, like, there is different shapes of the dark gray. It's like, God damn it, so I not only have to find the right piece of dark gray, I need to not care about the piece of white dark gray. And also see if it isn't like another shade, because it's just an old piece that has degraded over time.
Oh no, it's not fun, is it?
No. Thank God the enemy kind of gave up.
I was one of the rare people who just never really disassembled their Lego sets. Once it's built, it's built. Like, I don't like the idea of just pulling out the manual just to rebuild the thing I just disassembled. I did that for like majority of the Lego figures that weren't like complete waves, because it's just the individual, it doesn't matter. But like the whole waves thing, no, I didn't disassemble those ever.
Oh, like we just started playing with them after, like we usually just build it once, play with it, and then eventually disassemble to build something else for the other parts we had. And at the end, we basically had like 3 boxes of Legos, and if we wanted to play, we just like laid on the blanket on the floor and pulled on the boxes onto them and just scratch through it.
I mean,
it was actually a pretty good system, because you could find them somewhat decently, because you could like stretch them out a bit, and you could then like wrap the blanket in again to put them in the boxes again pretty easily. But yeah.
Yeah, but my system was, okay, it's in the box, tip it out. It worked. Made a mess, but it worked. It's a pain in the ass to find pieces you want though, because they all had to stay in the box.
Yeah.
It was like a big tubbed box though, so there was enough room. It made so much noise just shuffling through it.
Oh yeah, but that's the best thing.
Yeah, that's the best part about Lego. It's like, it's iconic because of the nature of it.
I think my parents didn't like it as much, because I usually went pretty early to the child.
No, where's that one piece? I need to go through all of this Lego to find it.
I know that this thing exists.
I saw that color 12 seconds ago, where the hell did it go? No, I already found that piece, but it's in the wrong color.
Yeah. No, I don't need this piece. Why do I keep finding it 5 minutes later? God damn it, there were all those pieces. There were like 10 of them. Let's double check.
What I said earlier about the symphony, that was a lie with the collection ones. I did bother like doing the whole... You ever seen the back of the instruction manual for the Barnacle sets, like you can do like a combined set thing?
Yeah, where you combine 3 of them.
Tried it out. Oh god, it's awful. They do not think it through. And the weird part is that combined form is usually canon to the lore. God damn it. Like its own individual thing. Like,
yeah.
Of course the combined figure is its own character. Why wouldn't it be?
Actually, I sure if this reminds me of Digimon or Digimon, depending on what I saw first.
I mean, Digimon is usually just the whole fusion logic, that's fine. Yeah, but for Barnacle, it's taking the sets, make new figure out of the parts they have. It's like, yep, new character, done. Get all the sets.
Yeah, I mean, it's still like kind of putting in this effort, that was, that was the idea. They can find the power, you know, they are stronger than the some of their parts would be.
Digimon's fusion logic is weird, because the main first one they show off in 02 was Pyldramon, and that one made sense because it was a combination of Exvimon and Stingmon. They had their assets and all that shared. And for some reason, that fusion gets to have a second variant where one is more dominant than the other. Because of course it does.
Yeah.
Totally not bias. But the other fusions are weird. Specifically, it was Ankylomon and Angemon made a completely different thing that shared none of the previous parts at all. It was like, is this even the same figure? It's like, is this even the same Digimon here?
Yeah, I just remember from Tira, it's like, then you know, just combine the fire and the light one.
Those ones make sense-ish.
Yeah, but it's like, okay, we just use this now from on our own, never use anything. It kind of was a bit mean to the others. It's like, oh yeah, you don't really matter anymore.
Yeah, pretty much just shoveled them out. What annoyed me about Tamers, Frontier, is that the whole arc thing was that it was like, you know, good spirits versus the bad spirits, and then Digidestined, whatever their equivalent was, they collected all the bad spirits, they don't use them for themselves. What's worse is that they encounter a group of another five. It's like, oh, this is where the bad spirits are gonna go to make them good again, you know? Make a larger team because it's supposed to be like 10 of these things. Nope, they go home. It's like, god damn it! Could have seen these guys come back as like good characters now.
Oh yeah, that's actually the reason. I mean, I noticed they used them for their mega evolutions all the time, so they kind of used them still. Like,
what a waste.
Yeah, like they never really came back as characters. At least used darkness as a standalone character.
Yeah, that was kind of nice. For once, darkness is used for good. I want one as a pet. I think I got it.
I think you can get something like it as a pet.
How? You weren't even looking there! Like... What's worse is that particular Parker was the main leader baddie. God damn it. Story-wise, you know, he's the most important one. Right, we have some money. Let's go spend it. If I can afford it, I think it's the most expensive one here. Let's
maybe
see.
Maybe one. Like, you got this amount, didn't you?
Yep. Hey. Is that all of them? Yeah, that's all of them. All left is the bonus levels, which are basically just grinding rooms if you want more money, but at that point, you've already generated enough.
It's like. The logic you really is like, you spend so much for the bonus rooms that amount, like, you can buy anything else already.
Basically what they are, if you ever bothered with Mass Effect 1's, like, that one DLC thing, which is basically the arena, it's just that.
I think I'm liking Total Levels, where it's like the ship and then you have like the MSP, the Amex Arena and the Citadel DLC, that's not good.
Yeah, pretty much. It's a bug, or a very unfinished set. That's literally just the waist piece and two arms.
The butterfly.
So, curious about the Mass Effect DLC thing. Did you ever bother with the arena for Mass Effect 1, or...?
No, from Mass Effect 1, not at all, like... Because, like, it's also, like, the gameplay is still a bit too long to be like, yeah, I'm just going to do just gameplay now for the sake of gameplay.
You want to know what you get for doing all of it?
Yeah, please. It's going to be disappointing, isn't it?
You get a vacation home that you barely interact with. You get a modest view. Not a great view, just a view. And it doesn't come back later on, not that I'm aware of. Like, without mods. I did it once, just curious what it was, and... it was alright. Not really worth the effort. I just kept constantly fight the ones you have to do the high score thing. Did it on the standard difficulty I was already at, and then just to kill myself because I was at a point and the level was too goddamn high, it's like... Okay, these guys aren't killing me fast enough. Better crank up the difficulty just so I can die faster.
Oh my god. They should have to kill yourself.
I don't think it was the case you could just leave the minigame. You had to die to get out or something like that, so... Oh, it worked. I did it for a holiday home that doesn't transfer over, really. I'm hoping, like, with mods it does transfer that data in, because I haven't bothered since the first time.
Maybe for the remaster?
Why would they bother with the remaster? Well, it's not even a remaster, it's just a port. Gotta think realistically here.
No, it definitely says remaster.
Legendary editions, big difference.
Yeah, I mean, because like all the time you hear about remasters, I just got fun in my head.
Yeah, the term gets a little lost nowadays.
Yeah. I mean, it doesn't help that like, you hear it floating around before it's even announced, so...
That's right.
It's not even like EA's fault at this point if they call it legacy system and everybody's expecting a remaster just because all the gaming channels and YouTube channels and stuff like that just scream at you with remaster.
I think, like, 2020 and 2019 were the years of remasters and remakes. Like, goddamn, there have been a lot more lately. It's like, it's either ports or, you know, remakes, remasters. Like, there's been more of those than original titles as of late.
Really think about it.
Especially on the Switch. The Switch is nothing but ports. It's like, okay, neat, where are the IPs? Like, they've just been doing nothing but porting all the Wii U tiles that didn't work. It's like, it did so well on the Wii U, better put it on the Switch, then it'll get money. We want our money, damn it.
Yeah.
Like, so far they have ported almost all the good tiles that were on the Wii U, making my Wii U redundant. It's like, why do we even have this thing?
Oh, so you can't just buy the Switch and not get everything.
Yeah, double price. Because of course they didn't discount them. I am glad though that people are discovering the games that were exclusive to the Wii U. Like, you know, they've finally been appreciated.
Yeah.
A good example is the Wonderful 101. That one's a good one. That was a sleeper game, that one. That was a Platinum Games title. It's an interesting title concept, really. The idea is that you think of it just like Power Rangers, but with 100 members. That's the best description I can give it. That's literally what it is. It's a Sentai game, but very exaggerated.
Okay, but it's still just single player, right?
It is a single person, yes, but you have a team of 100 people, pretty much.
Okay.
It's not that overwhelming, it's just... The idea of it is that you have, you know, different team members who have different abilities and such. The idea to change it, this was with the Wii U in mind. You had to draw out certain shapes on the screen to make that team member. So, you like, one of them's a sword, so you draw a straight line. One of them's a fist, like, for punching, so you draw a circle. Something like that. But because there's 100 members, you can amplify and upgrade that particular hero's power if you draw the particular item or thing bigger. So, imagine with 100 members with a really long sword, it's like, ooh, this does extra damage and it can reach all the screen.
Okay.
Like, it's a nice, fun, exaggerated, good game. Like, it's just a good time.
Okay, no, that definitely sounds like...
It's on PC, by the way, so go grab it.
I still need to finish the Ancient Gods and Prying Sons because I started playing that also, which actually is a pretty cool game, enjoying it.
Yeah, that's fair.
Bit of FTL-ish vibe, but...
Of course it is. System. That's double over. Eat.
But yeah, I mean, it has more story behind it, which is nice stuff.
I mean, Wonderful 101 has a story. It is very shonen, like, goddamn, it's all the tropes you expect. Ah, there it is. I was wondering where the last one was gonna be.
You already have it, yes.
Should kick in any second now. Any second. Come on. There we go. Okay, get this out of the way. It's blocking my path. Seriously, a jump button would not hurt.
Another power that you can possess.
I think I have to build this first, whatever it is. What is that for? That has to do something. Why would that even be there? Does it do anything? Okay. I'm not sure if that was stopping me going up the wall, but okay. Let's see. Where am I going? Oh, that way. Oh, I guess that was some part of the machinery? Maybe that activates downstairs?
Maybe?
I don't know. I didn't build this thing. Okay, well, let's go back and see what happens. And, yep.
Okay.
Weird, but alright. Don't know why I could have just ignored it. Alright, what has that done?
Probably the line there.
It's a gondola. Neat. Wait a minute, you can't make that in Lego. That's physically impossible.
That was...
slow. This is asking for a sniper. A little bit of splash damage would not hurt. Even if I've already asked about that.
Zephyr shouldn't do splash damage.
Not with that attitude. Alright, let's go down here. No, I can't. Sorry, there's greenery in the way.
If only there was a... Did you just kill the butterfly?
Maybe.
Not even the Faraka was that cruel. Are you really the hero here?
It's holding studs and I need it. Oh, the mini-map. The mini-map's weird. It's not three-dimensional. It's still registering that as part of its lair. Sorry, you were gonna say something?
Yeah, so for you the... And justify the means then. As long as you get the gold.
That was fast. Reed, you just did this just 5 seconds ago. You want me to do it again? It's not even like an extra thing to fight here. Not spawning enough enemies in here.
At least to knew what they had to do.
Wait, do those count back there?
No.
I need to see if the studs collect. As soon as he dies fast enough. God damn it. He has 2 health bars. I can't tell because this one enemy will not die yet. Yes, it does.
I think it does. Just only 3 months here.
This for the sake of convenience, I don't have to collect them manually. I'm not spawning enough. Really have to be thankful that this is much faster than the base game used to be.
Yeah. We will need 6 teams of this otherwise.
Oh yeah. It'd be like one character, one of the villains per for a live stream would be nowhere near as fast. Yeah, these flowers weren't here a minute ago. Pretty sure they spawn them in case the enemies aren't spawning fast enough.
Just killed everything.
Just burn it all down. There we go. Oh, damn it, I was gonna burn it all down, but now I can't. Thanks, you did nothing at all. Just was in the way.
The path did something.
It was in the way, that was it, he didn't do anything.
I mean, he did something, just not positive.
I'll collect these just in case the Aztec build something again, which it probably will.
It's a mechanic effect to use, yeah.
Oh, for once, I could just jump there, not actually build anything to get across. Done. Good sir, we should have made a gold buildable thing there. No, no, give him enough, just let him jump it.
Chris is having to use the abilities of the Roger and like, wow, two of these.
Watch as the platform falls.
She'll never look down.
I've seen too many of these things to know what happens next. Okay, we got money, let's go spend it. Oh, wait. There's nothing to spend it on.
Oh, well.
Good time not wasted. Where have we gone? Into the sphere thing eagle. Alright, so what's our next major set villain? He's got the clamps.
Where is he even in the room?
I don't know. Yeah. Maybe it's the start area we're beginning with? Nope. Alright. I believe that one was Sidorak, I think, if I remember his name. The movie iteration of his design looked much better. Because that one was literally just a raw exposed toe head at the time. Like, just with stuff strapped around it. It's not even a mask.
No, don't kill the butterflies. You didn't even collect this stuff, did you?
Let's see, I haven't got... Oh, there it is. I was gonna say, where's this mask? I needed to build this stuff. I'm not going back for that. In your shields, you don't need it. I need the shields. Everyone here has those things. Where do I get one?
It's if you complete all the bonus levels.
Of course.
In under 5 seconds.
No, I was gonna say. I wouldn't be surprised if that is a reward for bothering with them. Because I didn't.
It's actually don't know what happens if you do them all.
Yeah, I never bothered. Because why? It's just a waste of time.
But you don't know that. Maybe you unlock a secret gun.
Or maybe a new theme park.
Maybe, yeah.
Yeah, I really don't know why they exist. They're just for like a score attack. That's it. I really don't know why they exist. I believe the three are just based on the enemy types you encounter, which is the Borok, the Visorak, and the a third one I keep forgetting.
Okay.
Vaki? Is the Vaki?
Vaki, oh yeah.
That third one.
Yeah, Vaki.
That's it, they're just hordes of that one enemy, so I hope you don't get bored of them. Obviously the best one's the Visorak, because they're just the most raw, exposed enemies, because they don't have any BS behind them.
Yeah, you can just farm.
The Borok are okay, when they bring up the shield, so that's annoying. Visorak don't have any, they just exist and jump. But the Vaki just, they have a second health bar. That's not fun.
Yeah.
Where's the nearest destructible thing that'll pay off? I guess this will do.
And destroy it for more money.
Because that's how that works. Oh look, one just grew right here. See? There's a lot more here now all of a sudden.
This one does fun, that's cool.
No, I think this just spawned on their own terms. Hey, it's money. Making progress. This is literally grinding the game. Like, we joke about it in RPGs, but no, here's an actual game that's nothing but this.
And RPGs at least get then the skills out of it and then can find more efficient.
We heard you guys like seeing numbers go up, so we give you a literal one here.
It's almost like those clicker games.
Yeah, it pretty much is. It's got a somewhat satisfying sound effect for each thing you collect.
Oh well, it get me, so...
I'm sold, I'll buy 12!
Ooh, I can pay real currency to actually... real money to get it even faster.
I mean, you do, because, you know, I paid money for the discount to pay for more money.
Genius.
This mask was given away. I wonder why. Will there be a climbing sequence again?
Maybe.
I mean... Oh, damn it. That's the wrong way. Because since I have the money to spare, I probably should just go spending on the damn extra elemental upgrades, maybe. I'll think about it. All they do is just open doors, that's it.
Yeah, but in those doors you should get more stats,
money. So. In theory, but we're at the end of the game.
But, I mean, at least it would let you progress a bit faster.
Just a smidge. Hey, maybe we'll see a gold canister for once.
I mean, we've seen them in the last levels of each one, it's just that one room.
I think there is extras in the boss room. Maybe I'll bother with that one. Let's go faster. There's the gold thing. It's right there. Guess what we're doing again? Hopefully past this area will be the boss room. It's just long enough to warrant it.
Could be a...
blue studs there, and I can't collect them.
Is it the third golden thing you have to do now, or the second?
Yeah, you lose count, because they'll do the same thing. Get thing out of the way, it'll move itself out of the way. Let's get this, because gold's worth more than silver.
It seems logical.
And for some reason, blue is better.
Yeah, that's where I kind of it's going off a bit.
How do I get up there? I was just there and it's locked me off. That's not fair.
I didn't pay attention.
If only I could jump. Come on, screw your second health bar. There we go.
I did give you some blue ones.
Move thing out of way, that's it.
Yeah, he still did his job. Oh no, it's actually not finished yet.
Hey, you missed one.
Just waiting there for you.
My god, is that giant thing moving? I'm stunned. I can't do anything whilst this is going on.
I just have to watch. I mean, this is the most interesting thing that probably happened in this last time.
Door. Next. is the way out. There it is. That's where the guy just fell in. I mean, this looks like an arena. I guess I have to open it up first.
God, then you have to get it again to hurt him.
Probably, knowing how this game works. Just collect all the things, yay. You can tell we're getting bored by this. Because it's the same gameplay for the entire game.
I need to talk about some random stuff again.
This is my fault, I picked a Lego game and knew what would happen. nope, enough. Next one.
Yeah, there's even enough the robots where we could kill each other now.
I mean, that's mildly fun every time we get bored. Wait, oh, okay. I've missed a mask at some point, I didn't even notice. Didn't care to collect it. Not that it matters to the score anyway, or anything really. Where was all that a minute ago?
Did they just jump down there?
I think so, I mean they're already down there. But why get down there where I can collect the studs for free? Must be a safety mechanism just in case things go wrong.
Yeah.
Now there it is. There you go, second complete. Again. Oh, those are eggs.
Okay, you need to switch to the fire one.
Yep, okay, getting rid of the arachnid now. Just burn it. Burn it all.
Just let go of the D&D sessions.
I just devolved for the Rachni in Mass Effect 3 with the nest.
Yeah. I mean, it's the bad card.
Just burn it. Burn it all.
Yeah, yeah. So, what did we get done? Permanently. Okay.
Okay, there's no gold thing to build here. Guess what we're doing?
No, there's one down there.
Is there? Oh, yeah, so there is. But this is shop on the mini map. That's cheap. Bang, bang, bang. Now it's on the mini map.
Guess you don't want, maybe.
There's three structures here. Guess what we're doing for three times.
I don't know. Oh, that's excitingly waiting for it.
A small part of me wishes this is just, you know, the last of these bosses we have to do. No, there's another world's worth of this.
Yeah.
And then that's it. I give you this. The final boss definitely changes it up just a tiny bit. So, somewhat makes up for it.
Yeah, yeah. This does is pulling quite a few of them.
By changing up, I mean there is no requirement for hero mode, I'm aware of. I hope. Please.
Shoot it down.
I'd rather just shoot it down, that's mildly more interesting. At least I feel like I'm making progress.
I mean, yeah, I'm making progress, just slowly.
Okay, that's two. Rules of three, same on one.
What happened to this?
No, just pride.
He's from the close one.
Yeah, he is. Okay. So there's nothing but Visirag here. I should just be blowing them all up.
No, you should burn them, they're spiders.
No, I'm burning them with fiery explosions. They burn by default, just by touching it.
I don't get the feeling that you're going to pick a fireball after seeing what you're doing right now.
Mm-hmm. I'm really glad I found this mod exists. Like, I really was ready just like, okay, the game should go by quickly. It's just a kiddie game. I'll just go launch the PS2 version. What's this? PC version? It's faster? It's easier? Okay. Okay, that over with. Okay, what kind of beam projectile does he have? He's obviously gonna have one. Is that it? Is that his main projectile thing that isn't a beam?
No.
That's boring. All the other ones had like that kind of thing, what I'm doing right now. Yeah, and he's a disappointment even to himself. Which is very accurate to his character, actually. This is the most accurate portrayal so far.
So he actually wasn't the baddest in the movie, though, then?
I mean, yeah, except, you know, Rudako stepped him up completely.
Okay.
Like, he was just there as a title, really. He wasn't really much of a major villain.
Okay, that's fair.
The idea of him is that he was supposed to be the king of Visorak, but no, that was really Rudaka. He's like, let him have his fun with his title. Just keep the seat warm whilst I go do the actual work.
Maybe distract the heroes for a few minutes so that I can do important stuff in the meantime.
Yeah, that's it, exactly. You. Come on, drop that shield, you know you wanna. Make it easy for all of us. I swear, it's not always like this.
Never happened before.
Oh, he's just really disappointed in himself. Oh, there he goes.
Yeah, that looks like spam.
How can you be bad at this game? It's like one of the most easiest ones out there.
I don't know, like...
Suspicious.
Hey, cutie. Makes it suspicious to me.
A little bit, yeah. Also, this is a group channel now? Who are you referring to?
Probably not me.
Alright, the game just told us, hey, you got money, you should probably go spend it. Okay. We'll believe that for now. Doubt.
I'm just waiting for when we're getting asked to do something.
Yeah, where's the bot advertisement? Sorry, if you're actually an actual person, we apologize. We've just seen our fair share of spammers.
Yeah. Sorry, we're like this, but...
It's hard to tell. Let's see, I'll see him. I'm just upgrading who's the main and which one appears the most. What, wasting money? I don't know what you're talking about.
No. Spend a million with the internet.
There's nothing to spend it on. There we go. That'll do. Look, they got a plus icon on now. And, oh, goddammit, might as well. If I got two left, I might as well do all of them.
Yeah.
Not like it costs anything. You have to do it one at a time, though. All these upgrades don't do anything until it reaches the end. You might as well just make one big one. Jaller. Hey, look, it's the main character. Of course, he's saved him for last. Also, why is he the only one that has the gold armor? Everyone else is has the silver thing.
Because he's the main character.
He's the main character. Totally not biased at all. Yeah, he's the only one that has the gold armor. That's not biased whatsoever. Alright, let's go get our Paraka. Zactan. Okay, so, is this one gonna require gold or not?
Sorry?
Is this one gonna require the gold thing or not? That's the question.
Probably.
Let's see. Alright, since we got the character upgrade, if there is a gold thing, we can actually intentionally look around for extra points. There's no audience, it's just us.
maybe have audience here.
Yeah, go on, since might as well. Yay! Okay, there is a gold thing. I've no idea where it is though. I can't see because of the bloom. I still have to find the masks though.
There is a gold thing on the other side, so I think you should get that now.
Hang on a minute. Gotta get the priorities. I want to get the things so I can be invincible right now.
I'm dying that you're actually not invincible already because of the upgrade.
But I could be invincible sooner.
I mean, that you probably don't die because you have all the silver armor parts now.
Build this now. I'm gonna go do the gold thing now, so those points don't go to nothing.
That's smart. Let's see.
Oh, that's a big hit. You say you could have used the hand. It's bad.
At least you can watch that it's bad, that makes it okay to make bad puns.
And just like that, we got all the gold casters, that was easy.
You didn't really have to look for them either.
It only took an entire game just to get these things. I'm not sure if there are upgrades needed for the Paraka. I think they don't really have an upgrade meter, which is weird.
It's just extra, so...
Yeah, it's just weird that, you know, you can replay these stages to play as them, but they don't have an upgrade meter.
That was great, yeah.
Next! That's another hand. We flipped the animation, completely different.
You should have flown up for the first time, shouldn't you?
Oh no, it's different. There's that bug again.
Oh, he's going to escape now.
Okay, is the gold thing still here? Nope, okay, it's just one on one. Alright, just gotta wait for him to drop the shield. Or we'll to clear out the enemies first. Is it one of those?
Was it? Before, I think he just drops the shield, right?
Hold on a second. Is there another gold thing? Because I can't see it. There's too much bloom.
Oh, there is.
Yeah. Sorry, it matches in with the coloring so well.
Yeah, I didn't see this.
If you can't see on that screen, that shows how hidden that is. Like, you have the better visibility than I do. I've got so much bloomage on my screen. And for some reason, from my visibility, it's like amplified by 10. Right? I don't even know what this thing right here fully is. I know it's a waterfall, but it's like, where's the water? I can't see it.
It's right there.
It's just nothing but white.
Probably what is it to be a rethink again, right?
Hang on, I'll get triggered in a second. Come on, just give me enough studs. There. Okay. Rules of three, so this will be the last one, then just do it manually.
Uh-oh.
Ha!
Look, the body had you, teacher. Nice.
It can only work on things of certain size. He did it funny, he sounded like a carjack. Oh, now he's gonna be on the ground in person. Now we just got hit eight times or some crap.
No, what time?
Okay, three. I'm trying to remember how the Lego games did this health bar logic. Was it like, were they just temporarily invincible until they just decided to give in that you could actually hurt them?
Probably.
The health bars in the main Lego games were weird. They didn't have this whole, you know, extra armor on the health thing. They were just literally, they just wouldn't take the damage, so they just accepted that they can. Come on, drop the shield. I've escaped from my prison permanently this time. I'm not going back again. Hey, what's that you're shooting at me? Water! My god, no! He's lasting a little longer than he should. I'll just accept the damage, goddammit. I'm shooting you where it's supposed to. Come on. I'm shooting at it.
I play invincible again.
Also. What is this? Damn, back to the cell.
And then she actually always dropped it, like, she could just fly away with it.
Oh, we got a disc this time. Neat. Guess whose that would be? Starts with a V. Oh, whatever your region's equivalent. It's Vakama.
Yeah.
Okay,
I have him as a set, but.
Oh, same. Alright.
I can't find the mask anymore, which bothers me.
You don't have his mask?
No. Maybe I still have it, but I don't know where, but.
Alright. Last one. Let's get this quick. I want to show off the goddamn zoo. Oh, this one just finds its own home. Okay. No mask here. Let's keep moving. What do you mean have to destroy the things? I'm not going to destroy the things. I do what I want.
But you need those to request anyways.
I don't want to blow up the things. Maybe I want to do things differently for once. Like, build this if I wanted to. I'm going to build this. I want to be constructive.
I'm feeling happy now.
And there's nothing here. Why is this even here? There's nothing here. Why even have this buildable thing if there's nothing gonna be in here?
To disappoint you.
Yep, it worked.
It's a children's game, like you gotta teach you some lessons about life.
My disappointment is immeasurable, my day is ruined.
I didn't expect anything and I'm still disappointed.
Not enough enemies spawning here to make this a good one. Where the studs at? Oh, there we go. I can't build it, goddammit! Well, the trouble getting those upgrades, I can't even build the damn things.
It's back into build
it. I don't have the mask for it. That one.
Oh, okay, You have to look for the mask, I guess.
There's not one here, it's on the other side of the bridge, the very one I'm trying to build. Oh, yeah. How'd you miss?
That's XCOM.
God damn it. Oh, that's weird. I just decided to turn this direction. There's just a hole here. Aren't you supposed to drop out of that?
I think it's a secret passage if you have unlocked everything.
What is this, Doom?
Yeah.
There we go. Okay. Progress can resume. Thanks. Really, really helpful. Nah.
You can progress, so it is helpful.
Okay. Oh, goddammit, we just did this! nope, can't build that.
Do you have all masks if you replay this game? Replay them?
There is no new game plus, you just replay stages, just like any other new game. But that one requires beating the final boss, so I can't physically do lore. They really do want you to replay the game twice. It's kind of why I've been ignoring them, it's just like, there's no point, I'm gonna replay the game anyway.
You're gonna, you're not going to.
No, obviously not, but you know, the point being is like, there's no point doing it now if I'm gonna be replaying the stages anyway.
Yeah. I mean, same way with the, when you get like, it still feels good just for me to get them, even in the story mode, it's like, haha, I got this one in story mode, even though I need to replay it to get all of them.
Well, it is beneficial to get some of them, like, the problem was that it required me to having the tower fully upgraded to unlock some of the exclusive gates, but I'd still be missing out on that, the Paraka paths.
Yeah.
So even if I got all the tower ones, I'd have to replay it again just so I could get the stuff. In theory, I would have to do it 3 times, really, if I did it that way. I'd rather replay twice than 3 times.
That's fair, yeah. What? What a change of plans.
Think smarter, not harder.
I should do that more often.
Eh, too much effort. Oh, wait. Ooh, I fill this thing up with water, even though my gun can just shoot that. Oh, it's Diagon Alley, obviously.
Nice. That actually was really worth it.
Oh yeah. Sometimes it pays off. There we go. Nope, not doing any of that. Just gonna go down here. Down by me. We're just gonna go straight to hell. Okay, welcome. Okay, welcome to the new live stream of Doom Eternal. Or we're starting with hell.
And you're already using your punch to get to the crack.
Blood punch. Let's see, I gotta cross here. I've already got that filled the meter. Yes, mate, coming through. So red. Oh, don't ever, like, play, like, don't have, like, a red screen on, like, in a dark room or anything. That ruins your eyes. Especially when it suddenly turns to a bright color. It's like, ah!
I can imagine, yeah.
Had that happen to me with Rayman Origins, I think it was? One of the Rayman tiles. Like, basically, the entire thing was just this color set. Then it suddenly transitioned to bright blues. It's like, ah, damn it, my eyes.
My eyes.
Yep.
Have an epic battle.
I think this guy does fear? I think that's his ability, because he was the most prominent in the movie, so...
Yeah, I think it does Yeah.
Well, the rare times they acknowledge the powers these things have. Oh, I gotta build a thing, I don't wanna build a thing.
Right.
Is there anything exclusive in here? No, not really. Damn it. There's not enough enemy spawning.
There's no bonus rooms, right?
I can build this, whatever this is. Ah, a redundant set. Everyone builds these things. You do that just to make sure none of the parts go anywhere, that's it.
Yeah, the reserve parts is just sticking together to build something out of them so they'll put together.
Oh, you know, you're bored, you just need something to make. Come on, die faster. You're hawking all the enemies back, give them to me. That one blew up. There we go. I don't remember why I do this one for last, because I remember distinctly that these ones just took the longest.
Oh my god.
Yeah, the red ones variants aren't that fun. Supposed to be the coolest one, but it's not. It's boring.
Red was always overrated to me.
This is taking way too long already. Should have done the second one by now.
There actually isn't spawning any enemies at the moment.
No, they're just hogging them all at the back. Not enough. Come on, spawn them in. Where are they? Need more than just one entry point for these things, it's not enough. Oh, that's so slow. I gotta do this 3 times. Oh, for God's sake.
So
just
close.
Tipping the edge, come on. Anything, a singular stone would be enough. Die faster. There. One.
Yay.
Maybe they'll open up some gates. We'll close them. It's gonna close them, isn't it? Oh, that's the opposite of what we want. Stop. No. Oh, wait. Is he gonna... Oh, okay. I guess okay. That's convenient.
Can you work over to him now?
Yes.
Just lost up.
Excuse me? How does that make him lose his health, though?
He just is afraid of you, because you're the Doomslayer.
Oh wait, so now I can just hit him directly? Since no other gold thing here. Yep.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, this is easier. Better than doing this 3 times over.
Maybe that's why it took so long, so...
Maybe?
So only have to do it once.
Need to move though. He's not gonna adjust correctly.
I think you can get away with just staying.
Yeah, let's just see how far this goes.
This is stupid. It's just like airing up here.
I wanna put like in post, just put in like Dragon Ball's Ultimate Battle thing, that Ultra Instinct thing. It's just, I'm somehow dodging everything just by not moving.
I'm moving so fast that like you're standing still.
It's getting desperate for hurting me just by touching me. It's like, God damn, just take some damage for God's sake.
Tell me whether Rocky touched you with this thorn.
With this figure. This barnacle figure, we have that 1-to-1 scale. Come on, drop the shield. Fire plus fire, doesn't seem to work.
You can fight fire with fire.
Just need a bigger fire.
More, yeah.
I think I'm burning the tree down. Oh no, I can't shoot now, I have to move. Anyway. It's really persistent, not dropping the shield.
You can outlast them.
There we go. Done. Oh, that was close. Almost lost two masks there. Jesus. Moving on. At least take the staff.
They bite them.
Ah, cartoon logic. My favorite. You study the school of Bugs Bunny, don't you know?
It's a my decision.
Okay, almost there. Three more to go. I can't visit the store, there's nothing to buy. I've literally bought everything.
You've ruined him.
Have I ruined him if I bought him out of a store? There's nothing to sell.
How is he going to make money now?
He has all the money. He literally farmed this entire island's worth of its money. He has the economy.
But now he's going to get free to spend it on stuff that he doesn't need, and then he won't have anything to sell anymore and can't buy food.
Well, that's his problem. He caused it. Why do they put that mask if I'm already wearing it? It's weird.
Because they didn't think this game through.
No, they did not.
I mean, there's a checkpoint because you walked 5 feet.
Maybe they meant the stages to be longer initially? Maybe not explain the amount of checkpoints? Like, maybe they're supposed to be just all one big stage, which makes sense, I suppose. But then you gotta do this for an entire world's worth.
Then you can ride at the back of the box.
God, how many levels it has?
24 levels. Because you know, it doesn't matter how long the levels are, if you have a lot of them.
Hang on, I need to. Sorry, that description reminded me of the, what's on the back of the box for Sonic Heroes, because technically it's the same game 4 times over. I'm not joking. Hang on, just quick pause. Hang on, let me just grab my copy. Sorry.
Damn it, no, I have to talk on my own.
No, this is like my this is like my third copy, because I accidentally bought 2 copies of Sonic Heroes because I thought I didn't have one for GameCube. Oops. let's see. Oh, no, it doesn't. It just says 4 teams, 12 superheroes. Technically, it's 4 teams, but 3 of the same character types. No, that's it. It doesn't say anything like the amount of stages it has. It's just like, you know, the selling factor is that it's 4 teams and they're like each character is unique. No, they're not. They all function the same thing.
I mean, it didn't say that they're unique. It just said 4 teams and 12 heroes.
But with the description of 12 heroes, you think, oh, well, that's like 12 unique characters, they all act differently. No, they do the same thing. But more explicitly true, like, some have something unique, as in, oh, this character can, it does its attack slightly differently. But slightly so minute, like, you don't even think about it. One at the back of the box of that said, like, you know, it's got like 42 stages. In reality, it's just like, no, it's just 8 or 6. Just, you know, you play it 4 times over. You have to replay that game 4 times over to get the true ending, goddammit.
I can die again. Before.
And on top of that, you gotta make sure you collect all 7 of the Chaos Emeralds, because, you know, Super Sonic, that's a requirement. At least that game's merciful with the fact that it doesn't matter which teams collect all seven, as long as you got, like, the conglomerative seven, whatever.
Okay.
It's fine. Like, it is shared. Thank God. Can you imagine having to collect all seven emeralds four times over? With those, that game's special stages are horrendous. No, never again. I've already done it, I'm not doing it again.
Yeah, I think I actually turned those,
you did, late in the Chaotix one, I think.
I just remember, like, the Crocodile and
yeah, that was the Chaotix. But, I'd say the Chaotix for Sonic Heroes was the most distinctly different, because you weren't just playing the same game on a different difficulty. That one was like a mission-based mode, where you had to do specific tasks, pretty much. Like, collect a certain amount of rings, find the lost chow, you know, thing like that. A slight spice up, not by much. just wait till we get to the next game, though. Teaser, I suppose, a slight spoiler. It's a Sonic game, but don't say the title of it, because that'll spoil everything.
I mean, I already kind of forgot it. It's one of the good games, right? It's one of the absolutely great ones.
It's, okay, it's the first game of its series from the Sonic lineup, but the first one was bad, but the one after it actually improved significantly. That's a, does that say any good hint? Am I cryptic enough?
Maybe. I'm sure some people will get it.
It's before it gets good. Where am I going? It's that way. Ah, that way. Let's go up. Wait a minute. That looks destructible.
Secret room.
Hey, look, this one didn't even need any requirements. You just have to blow the thing up.
It's a sound logic.
Being rewarded for exploring with curiosity? My god. Get out of the way. You're slowing me down. Don't force me to get the bombs out, because I will. Yeah, go on. Actually, I think this is the main pathway. Oh, I have to do that too. There you go, bridge. I think.
Yeah.
It looks like a bridge. Now, for God's sake, get out of the way. Your corpse is blocking me. Alright, where's the gold thing? There's gotta be one right here somewhere.
Yeah, it's sort of.
But that's the most redundant checkpoint ever! It's just a few feet! Oh, there it is. Can I just skip it? I can see the jump platform right there. No, you must jump from over there, not over here.
And you can also jump with these platforms, you know.
No, I only work on the green platforms, and it has to be a very specific angle. Oh no, wait. It's fine. There you go. I'm just gonna save it until I lose the mask. Wait a minute. I'll just get a refill now.
And you can't use the mask in fancy killing stuff, right?
Yeah. It's a free refill, just take it. You just stop shooting your projectiles, it's annoying. A lot of insects here for some reason. I mean, the Borok are insects, so. Wait for it to get back up. There we go.
The fact that you have to wait.
You have to wait. The hitbox does not exist until it's fully standing upright.
Damn invulnerability frames.
Mm-hmm. It's better to stay down on the ground, really. Otherwise, the chance of winning. Oh god, this one's a slow one again.
It should be close to them because you don't have a...
Oh, shit.
boss fight in that one, right? It's just getting the orb.
Yeah, the fights. Yeah, this one's just the orb. But yeah, the boss fight's probably just equally as bad. I'm just gonna press this again.
Oh, shit.
This entire game.
A panic dance.
I mean, yeah, if you want, hang on. I love this dance. I probably should do Ghost Trick at some point. Maybe a little bit later on. That's basically just a visual novel of the game.
Yeah, we don't need to talk then.
The voice acted. Yeah, you gotta read. I mean, text to voice.
Okay.
Maybe you could be a character if you want.
Yeah, I mean, I should practice a bit of making different voices. I mean, I could be a DM, but I just feel like that. It's not the same.
Just see as practice for diversity.
Yeah.
Oh, I know where this exists, so I can jump down from there. Well, might as well, since I'm here. Packing is over. Okay, a built thing, now what? Yeah.
Built more.
How do I get up there?
Jump.
The temp bug will stop me from getting the prompt. Whee!
There's no way you can get up there any other way.
Of course. Why can't you just use your hands to do it? Much more efficient.
Fighting fire with fire again.
Beams with fire. These are the support beams, you're not supposed to take these down.
I mean, they placed them really badly.
That was short. Oh wait, oh, there we go. I can't leave the cart, it's kept me locked in. Oh, I can't.
It's not the time.
I think I have to get back on the minecart in a bit, maybe? Oh no, the track ends, but I can't get across for some reason. No, I could clearly just walk that. It's just short up.
You're not that strong or agile.
I'm strong, just not smart. Think smarter, not harder. There he is. Good enough. Wait. He's just staying there. We gotta take his advice. I'm not getting up. He can't kill me if I don't get up. Shows what he knows. I didn't know they actually could just stay still. I think that was a bug, but it's like, I'm glad it was allowed to kill him. It's like, wait a minute.
Yeah.
I stay invincible if I stay down. I'll do that. Nope.
Not thinking.
Great idea, genius. And how do you plan on stopping me with that?
I mean, he knows what he is. He's not going to stop you. He's just going to slow you down. By staying dead. And not allowing you to think.
No, don't acknowledge me. I'm dead. Just ignore the corpse.
Yeah, he's delaying you forever.
I think it's just this room, they just like to stay down. It's hot in here, man. I just don't, man.
Oh, it's the rest.
There we go. Anyway, I've already built this thing. You can't just reuse the same model twice.
They can, and they clearly have.
This one's the worst one for build thing. It's just shuffle piece. That's it. That's all it does. Ooh, that was a good one.
Right, that's nice.
When it works well, it works well. Just big boom. Too bad they didn't build anything on that meter, though. They just handed that one away. sir, we ran out of spaces for that last gold canister. Where do we put it? I'll just put it at the end. No one knows. Guess he was right there. We just let him go.
Maybe.
Okay, two more to go. Almost there. Almost done.
Yeah.
Actually, what is our total? I haven't actually checked the numbers. I'm not padding. What are you talking about?
Uh-oh.
You know what we could spend the money on? Let's see. Let's spend it on the useful hints. Yes.
Oh, God.
Oh, press the fire button to fire. Oh my God, what is hint 2? Press the interact button to interact. Hint 3. Well, actually, I could have used that earlier.
Yeah, I was about to say
that. Well, let's see. Collect Lego to buy stuff. When your hero mute is full, you are invincible. I think I've noticed that. You don't say. How many hints are there? They're just 10? No, it's like... it's quite a bit here. What's the most expensive? It's 20. Let's see. To improve your level, buy more things. And the second most important one, look out for... oh yeah, constructions. They call them constructions. It's weird. The official is the official Lego term. They call them constructions. It's so weird.
I love the first sentence. It's like, hey, if you're struggling with this game by not pressing the fire button and dying all the time, maybe try actually fighting.
Try aiming. We've already got the auto aim cranked up to 12. This is Rutaka, I think it is. He's got four arms. he is actually. How does the extra arms work? They just like tuck away behind his back. So he just sets them out when he needs to.
I hope you can see that.
Well, that's what the set does. But here he just has them dangling on the side. Just pretend the lightsabers is totally the same thing. Alright, there's no masks here, but I will claim that though. Okay, that way. Right.
Okay, the rest of it is safe.
We got a tower here, is immune to fire. Pretty sure that's how that works, right?
No, I mean, his mask only gave him shielding, so maybe.
I did hate that. I always assume that logic is like, oh, I have the ability to shoot out fire. That means I'm immune to fire now, right? And then it just never applies. It always never applies. It's like, but I make fire. I have to be immune to it.
I mean, if you're wearing a fireproof suit as well, kind of, but...
yeah, but then they don't make fire, then do they? It's only this game that you actually make fire and is immune to it. Fire, not so bad.
Fire, good.
Very good. Very good. Get back up, I haven't finished with you yet. And cycle again. Best game of 2021!
Cyberpunk, what now?
Well, gotta give Lego this. They define the standards of what should be the most stable.
Yeah. We didn't encounter any game breaking glitches or bugs.
Not yet. Just wait, final boss defeats the boss, but the cutscene is a trigger.
Boss just T-poses the entire time.
Yeah, I actually, small part of me wishes that that will happen. It'd be the greatest way to finish the game.
And enough of that in the XCOM run.
Or Mass Effect 3, goddammit. Game kept breaking at the final scene.
Was it the modded run or the...
It was, yeah, the modded run, like, you know, what we did for the live stream. It kept breaking on the damn final scene. I had to do it off screen just so we can actually stay stable enough to continue.
Oh yeah.
Did like three times. It's like, okay, this is not gonna fix itself. We gotta do it off screen.
Yeah, because you even wonder about it. How could I forget that?
Because that was the solution from the start after post Mars, was that if I didn't have it on screen for some reason, it stayed stable. So I just run with the logic and, oh, look at that, it fixed itself by not being witnessed.
Don't witness me.
I'm sorry, but under a lot of pressure, he keeps punishing me with these mods. Oh, water only section. Better get off of this as soon as possible.
That volcano?
Yeah, in a volcano. Wait a minute.
That's not how volcanoes work.
I mean, yes and no, kinda.
And,
volcanoes are weird.
Yeah. Might look the way.
Let's see what's this way. This looks important. Get off my platform, I need it so I can build it with a different character. Actually, where is the thing? Oh, there it is. Oh wait, I have to do this as- what? What? What game is this? I have to build something as Holly, not Hoogie? What game is this?
Maybe you should have paid attention to the tips more.
I'm sorry, that's the only build I've seen so far that didn't require Hookie. But what game is this?
Doing the best for last, it seems.
There's always room for a new surprise. And back to Hookie. Hey, Builder Man of Earth. Yeah, I missed. There we go. Ah, there we go. Okay, the universe is fixed.
I do have to use it to get done.
Yep. Just a simple lever would have done, but no, Hookie has to do it.
I mean, simple jumping off would have done it as well.
No, what's annoying is the fact that most of these things are active with a simple lever that anyone could do with their bare hands, but no. Hookie here has to do it because he's got the techno powers for some reason.
And he like, doesn't pull it, it's just like, ooh, I can...
I've got the force. Got...
Yeah.
The eye has a rocket launcher, that makes me cool. Now I got a grenade launcher that detonates, you're much more cooler. At least they're spawning the enemies here, thank god.
Yeah.
Come on, just drop some blues. I guess that one to something, maybe.
Probably just gives you more money. But
let's do that now. And it spawned a canister. Get out of the way, I need it. I need it. Let me in. He just happened to be in here. Get out of the damn. There we go. He happened just got himself in that spot, exactly where the damn canister is. I want it. I have it now. That's convenient. I guess he has to build the thing. And pull the lever. I'm guessing that way due to the mini map.
The lever, wrong.
Well, they got the one.
It could still be the one run.
The joke doesn't work if there's not two levers. Look, it's right there. Just use your hands. For God's sake.
This lovely just goes to black every time you get on it. Because they didn't bother doing the animation for them, they're worried about the bugging.
I think most of these guys have an intelligence of -2, so that's probably why they can't physically pull it. They're just too stupid to do so.
What should I do with this?
And Hookie's the only one competent with the intelligence of a bonus of 0.
I mean,
just smart enough to pull the lever.
Bonus of 0 is just your average intelligence, like.
Exactly. Just enough to pull the lever.
That's not bad, like.
But compared to the others, they physically can't out. They're too stupid to pull the lever. I was gonna say, his head's on backwards. Okay, what we got here? Oh, joy. Three times over, judging by the looks of it. Maybe a rare fourth.
No, that would be too cruel.
Yeah, I don't know, this game's gone, you know, done cruel things already. Please tell me the game was smart with the meter for this section. By the looks of it, yes. Whoever modded this particular stage must have remembered this bit.
Wait, where does he... I can he jump?
Yeah, that's unfair. Now I gotta build the thing just so I can get across. It didn't even... the gold thing didn't even do this. Oh, it does look like just a base 3, actually. Might not be 4 this time.
Yay.
This
enough
time.
Because whittling him down slowly.
As usual.
Same procedure as last mission.
Wait, what's he doing back there? He's not... okay, I was gonna say, what's he doing back there? He's not supposed to be there yet.
Oh no, he has a teleporter.
He has his transmission, goddammit. Build the thing. Do the thing again. Amazing cutscene. Excuse me whilst I build this bridge again. He's back over there again. At least you're supposed to be there this time.
Wait, is he?
Yeah, he's at the back. And now he's back here.
Take him to like on the next one so that he can take him better.
I think he's a little bit bugged.
I shouldn't have said Cyberpunk. It's basically cut from the game.
It's a Lego game. What did you expect? They're infamous for them being buggy. They set the standards.
I thought that was Bethesda.
No, Lego was first, then Bethesda came along, and then Cyberpunk just redefined it. Bethesda got lucky because they had a game that actually was pretty damn good, even if it's a mess.
But I mean,
then Cyberpunk came along.
Yeah, I mean, that's also not that true for Bethesda anymore. 76.
Not even half the man he used to be.
I have no idea in what state Fallout 76 is.
I think it's okay, but if you're planning on having a private server, you're gonna have to pay extra.
Okay, so because I can remember at one point there was like the...
Oh, you're only on the one private server, by the way.
It's bad. Okay. They introduced the other version for it, which had a lot of the features that were promised as, you know, base features. It's like... how did you think you can do this and people will fall for it after everything you've done with this game?
Well, apparently it's still in the positive reviews, which I'm pretty sure are bots, considering if I remember specifically that Bethesda E3 event thing, it was like 10 people in the audience that were just super hyped. Even though they should be at that point.
Hey, Brando. So.
Ooh, different mask shape this time. Alright, that's that done. We got one more to go, then the final boss.
Yeah. And we're about to again try and see if we're about to finish the game.
Okay. Please just be a direct confrontation, no extra fluff.
Should be, because they normally were.
There's a little bit of fluff here. Gotta build a thing. Wait a minute. I don't want to build it yet. Now I do.
Cutscenes, I get to the like.
This looks like an arena.
Checkpoint, you build a thing. That's actually kind of cool.
For once, they actually had a pretty good introduction.
Yeah, it's like, that actually is pretty cool. It was just like, yeah, I'm just going to assemble myself in front of you.
May only get the one good one. Alright, don't mind me, I'm just gonna go find the stuff. Maybe actually build a set for once. Let's see that one. I paid for this, I might as well use it.
Yeah. That's the first hero meter.
Stay hydrated, folks. Ah, that was quick. Alright, where's the buildable thing? That direction. I see three gates. Guess what we're doing?
Doing something three times in the video game.
Rules of three. Whoa! Rainbow is here. Five of them is your job.
I mentioned them like two times.
I didn't hear it.
Don't listen to me, it seems.
I legit did not hear it. I'm so sorry. It probably just happened during the middle of a cutscene where I can't hear you, because when those cut in, they cut in, I literally cannot hear you.
That could be it, yeah.
I'm so sorry.
Just sometimes I'm gonna set the team again, trying to game is about to finish it.
Oh, goddammit. Okay, that was when. Alright. Oh, better late than ever. I mean, he's got a little bit of content to see before we finish the game, so that's something.
Yeah, and he said this is his favorite game from childhood, so he did play it. It seemed like.
It has been improved. This isn't the original game, it's slightly modded. Which, by the way, you can get for free if you just look it online. there's the thing. Am I gonna build it? It's right there.
Is this maybe another one that you have to look for?
I have to wait for him to get over there? That's probably it. Let's see. Is he gonna jump over there? Just give it a minute. He'll do it. He'll do it. There he goes. And there we go. Oh, I see. You're in the gold form. Let me just get into the right position. Side down. One more. Great. And I've run out of things to pick up. Damn.
Really?
Alright, I have to do the old fashioned way.
By shooting it with a shotgun.
What's this guy? It's the first one I encountered.
It's a shame that this thing doesn't have a grappling hook on it.
That would be fun. All I can do is jump.
Again, it's a
honestly, the only good Paraka fight we had was the earth or rock, whatever it was. The one that was in the Coliseum, like sand one. That was the only good one because it was just a raw fight, no BS hero mode build up.
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, it was slow, but you know, props for being honest.
I mean, the others are also slow, if not slower.
Yeah, I suppose, but just like it was an honest fight.
Yeah.
Just keeps spawning. Is it nothing but these guys? Like, I don't like these things. The Varkeep, whatever they are, I keep forgetting their damn names.
Yeah, it's Varkeep.
So I have to kill them twice. It's so slow. Come on, die again so I can get your studs. There's nothing but Varkeep in there.
I mean, the humans will be spreading up pretty quickly.
I suppose, just be glad it's been tweaked so they built up faster. I'm assuming these guys drop more studs because of their nature. I'm not camping.
Okay. It's not fun camping if it's AI.
Alright, he's in there by default, so build the thing and finish the thing. Bird, go do thing. Now.
Tested the lava.
I mean, he's standing in it, so. Nice, fine. Alright, let's do water, because that makes sense.
Actually, it does, yeah. It's too sensible.
I don't have to move anymore. Nice shot. You missed. And if you did hit, it does nothing.
I action gameplay.
It's exactly how I remember it. Am I gonna be able to kill him before I lose the mask?
I don't think.
Right, you know what they say, fight fire with fire.
It worked.
Alas, I die.
Okay, well, did he just kill himself? Slap his own neck.
He's just on the ground dramatically dying. He hasn't lost any parts, usually it's the other way around. I mean, I don't want to kill him or anything. Nope.
I don't know if you're gonna do it.
Right, he had the best death so far, just for the fact that he did it dramatically.
Yeah.
This is the last damn mask, you better keep this one! Pew pew. Big spider go brr.
Run.
We saved the island, we've beaten all of the Baraka. Everything's a-okay. Now someone managed to miss a mask. God damn it. Oh, it doesn't matter.
So we can now check out the zoo.
Now we gotta do the final boss first.
Oh.
Cause you know it's one more Baraka to put in the list.
Okay.
Into the pit we go. Vezon. So, Vezon's supposed to stay imprisoned here, but for some reason he just hasn't. Right, is there any masks here? Nope, okay. Oh, actually, I have them already. That makes sense. Final boss.
And they all showed up at the same time.
I guess so. I don't think there is a hero thing to build here. It's just the door to make promise with. Alright, let's just plonk it in, open the door. What we got in here? Man, it's boring in here.
How did he escape before?
I don't know. It's not supposed to get out. Like, that thing's supposed to keep him here.
Must have really good persuasion.
Now, story-wise as to why he's imprisoned here is that he's the one that currently has the Mask of Life. But do you want to know where that mask is currently?
It's on the spider thing?
No, it's currently strapped to his head on the back of it. Like, if you look at the actual toy itself, it has, like, the sculpt of the Mask of Life on it. Well, I say that, it's the prototype design of it. He ended up redesigning it like this in the next wave.
Why?
I don't know, they were picky. What's worse is that they showed the proto model here once we defeat him, so keep a good eye on it because it changes in the next wave. Alright, that's all the stuff, and guess what we're doing?
Just shooting the thing.
Oh, right. It's gotta be the limbs. Forgot about that. It's not the head this time, it's the limbs! Completely different thing this time.
And why wasn't this a hint? It maybe even is one.
At least this guy isn't just keeping himself exposed hitbox all the time now, I suppose. I think it's more like the body? The limbs do go away eventually.
I mean, he doesn't have a shield, but you still need to wait for him to be vulnerable.
Might as well have a shield. Weak boss here. Oh, the music's already linked. It's so short. It's half a heart per hit. It doesn't even matter if I do a stronger attack, it's going to be half a heart every time.
Yeah.
This is the best boss ever.
I mean,
and he's only vulnerable when he does that two-arm lunge. That's it.
I think it's at least faster, like with the invulnerability to vulnerability phases than most of the other bosses. So I would say he's the best one.
I'm assuming something will change after we like take out the first three or four hearts, maybe. We'll see when we get there.
I don't think that they have second phases.
Well, I would say he has a second phase, just something changes. Mm-hmm. Come on, do that double lunge thing. You know you wanna. Ah, right. Lava. There's lava bad. Shooty at him. I don't see anything going down. I have to stand still. There we go. I got some. Well, I did something. And now he's not vulnerable. I think I just shot his tail, that's it. I didn't even notice it had a tail. Oh, now it's going after the limbs. Okay, hey. This is faster. Oh, but that one doesn't count anymore because that hitbox is gone. It is sequential.
They put it a bit dead one. Yeah, they give us some slack credit now.
Alright, at least they changed up the phases, gotta give them that.
Yeah.
And that one's gone. That one didn't get a unique cutscene for losing its limb. And that one's gone too. And now for the head, I suppose. Oh well, that's dead.
Ah, this is
gone. Oh shit, I'm on lava! Shit! Why did I decide to chill out here? Okay, cross for this fight. Ow. Oh no. Let me just go get anyone. Anyway, Props to this fight. No shield from here. You can just hurt it until it's dead. This is the best fight yet.
Okay, this is the best boss fight.
I'm just destroying all of its limbs it can stand on. Oh! See on his forehead, there's a mouse design on the back. It's upside down.
Oh, yeah.
Keep an eye out for that design. Why must I be changing this mass? Okay, who should win this?
Min.
Oh, never mind. This is mine.
Yeah, wonder why they
There's the mask of life. It looks completely different after this. We did it! We found the mask! And, yeah, that's it. That's how it ends. Except it doesn't. We don't get the mask straight away. After this, story-wise, the mask decides to have its own little adventure and went under the sea. Literally on its own, just decide, I'm going down this way. Have fun getting me at the bottom of the ocean. And that's why they went scuba diving in the next wave. Mask decided to have its own thoughts, like, nah, I've had enough of these guys, I'm going on my own.
Yeah, you didn't mask it enough of the game.
Pretty much. I'm gonna stick around for the next one. And that's it. That's how it ends. You don't even see if you save Matsunuri because, you know, the next wave is happening. Yeah, after that, you see these guys have a disco party.
Game.
Oh, what do you know? It is a Burton game. Totally the same guy.
Yeah.
Yeah, you get this nice.
It's just brother that decided to make games instead of movies. Didn't work out the same way, sadly.
Yeah, that was Banaku Heroes. For the credits, you just hear this, like, this disco remix, whatever, variation of the game's theme. I like it. It reminds me of the 2000s. It's very 2000s. So yeah, what do you think of Banaku Heroes and how it's a Lego game it is?
Yeah, I mean, it's like, in the MC I can have fun with it, but yeah, it's just grindy and like doing this all in like 2 hour session kind of shows a bit, especially if you're just watching.
But it's perfect for the kids, and apparently it needs to be third person or else it'd be too mature.
Yeah, I mean, I can understand that, like, I mean, because you just spend entire time shooting stuff, if you do some first person, might not be best for, like, children around 10 or something like that.
I mean, I do like that it being in third person, you get to see clearly who you're playing as, the toes and all that, but I'm curious, like, how different it would have been first person. Would there have been, like, how much unique animation was made just for the first person view? Like, that had to have been thrown out.
Yeah.
I mean, it wouldn't be like any reload animations, not that I'm aware of, because, you know, in this whole game there's no concept of ammo.
Yeah, but I actually would, like, if the gameplay would also change a bit, because, like, enemies in third person work not the same way as in first person, usually.
Hmm. Yeah, I suppose. But we may never know. Traveler's Tales, that's it. They've changed quite a bit since then. Although one of the developers for Traveler's Tales on YouTube, he was like Game Hunter or something like that. I can't remember what his channel name was, but he's very insightful for being one of the ex-developers for Traveler's Tales. Like, he's provided the information for everything they've done in the past before the LEGO conversion. They have some information about LEGO, but it's very insightful. Maybe there is some information about this. Actually, that is because of that channel I learned about the whole first-person thing about this game.
Okay, yeah. That's cool, yeah.
I'm sure there's some like leftover dev stuff that you might be able to tell. I need to look up the channel again. But it's impressive from Traveler's Tales what they did before, like for the Genesis. They're responsible for a few Sonic titles, naturally.
Yeah.
But they also did some other games, like how, like, technically impressive they did just to get, like, 3D effects to work on the Genesis, like, stuff like that. Like, it shouldn't be physically possible, but yet they did it anyway.
That is impressive, yeah.
It's just amazing to know how games were made with, you know, limitations and stuff and how to get around them. Because, you know, because of those limitations, you make great things.
Yeah, that's usually a thing.
Let's see, I think some of these credits might have been tweaked for the sake of the mod, I think. Maybe. I'm not sure if they tweaked the credits or not, so we'll see in a second.
Maybe.
Design a mask competition winner. Now, congratulations, that person in the UK. Yeah, that's it.
Was it you?
No, it wasn't me.
Oh.
I wasn't aware there was a contest for it. Let's go see if it's in the thing. Since it probably did show up in the last thing. Let's see if we see what that mask would be. Let's see. It's achievements. It really shows. Let's see. Is that it? I don't think that's the prize one. No. I think the prize mask is like on the bottom right here. If we've been picking up masks that we clearly have been ignoring. Oh, well. Alright. We got time. I don't care. We got time just for a little bit for the zoo. We bought all the stuff. Might as well.
Yeah.
Right. Oh, right. We gotta play as him who key for the entire thing, because of course the horns only work for him.
Wait, what does only work for him?
Alright, so we gotta build the sets, naturally. And
I can only he can build it because of course only he can.
Can't see because the bloom. Alright, so let's honk the horn and see who comes first. You just spam it until someone comes across. It's like a sandcastle.
No, nice. Thank you, Semicron.
So yeah, if you wanted to see some of the Procketers doing stupid shit, here you go. So let's just build what we got here and see what we want to do. Well, this one's a bar. This requires three. We gotta do this with three people. And I'm gonna need one more. Or two, sorry. Oh, it's a shooting gallery. You can definitely tell that the devs had fun with the
proper
designs and what they could do potentially. Like, they were stupid enough to look at it as it is. That was just a beach, that's boring. No, this is just a boring one. What's this one? This one is a raft of some variant, and this one would be. I just want to see what the options are first. Another boat. Alright, we got time. We got time for one of these two, so which one do you prefer?
Left on the wind, so.
Right, who's coming ashore? Just gotta wait for someone to get here. Someone's getting here. Got nothing to buy, damn it. It's him. Makes sense.
Yeah, that should be.
Alright. Set sail. There he goes. You know, I don't remember Lego being this buoyant. Not expensive.
Shouldn't he like water?
I don't know, these guys aren't exactly elementals. Alright, let's see what else we got here. We're not going to do all of them because that would take too long, so we're just going to do what we think might be funny. This one is... it's a seesaw. Okay. Yeah. Oh, wait a minute. want to see what this one is first. Oh, it's a bucking bronco. We gotta see the bucking bronco. roll up for the bucking bronco. See how long you can last. As soon as someone gets over here, of course. No idea who what determines it. Okay, here we go. We got one. Yeah, this feels fitting. It seems Western-like. Yeah. Must be the colors. He's enjoying himself. Alright, crank out to 11. You can do it! Oh. Damn, you're only second off of the record.
Try again.
Alright, that's this side of the island. Let's go to the other side. Out of the way. Come on, faster! Faster! Come on, you're blocking the way. Come on, move it! No, you're not coming here. There we go. Sorry, it's the only way to make him move.
It's effective, right? Works in real life as well.
Alright, so we got a disco floor and a DJ set. So I don't know which one triggers what. I'm gonna assume this one is for the DJ set because it was on the right. Yeah, the box was.
Yeah. If the DJ has to be people dancing because it on the mix.
But you get a different interaction depending who's like what's focused on. So. So this guy is going to the DJ set, I think. It's literally a gear for the disc.
Yeah, that's cool.
I'm a wreck! at least it was good for the moment. Yeah, like, genuinely listening to the game's soundtrack is actually surprisingly decent considering what it is. Ah, here's the bar. Yeah. Maybe a good drink will fix him up.
Let's get wasted.
Alright, we need another one. Come on, someone else has got to listen to this thing. That's two. This one's crying three. And number three. Please tell me he's gonna be the one serving as well. Oh no, he's getting a drink. Okay. Understandable. What be your poison? Here we go. Of course, as the barman, you gotta show off.
Yeah.
Subvert the expectations there. You expect them to fall back on his head, but no, it's fell on their heads instead. Let's see, what's this one? Oh, it's a gym. Okay. Let's just see what's over here first. Oh, I know this one. It shows I've been here once or twice. Okay. Yeah, that's it. Alright, we'll do these last two and then that's it.
Yeah, that's fair.
Okay, I think this one requires another three, considering how many objects there are here.
Probably.
Come on. You need to get some exercise after all that drinking. That didn't happen. Just asking for... Oh no. There you go. Feel the burn!
Game.
Oh. 5 minutes. At least he's trying. Ish.
Didn't have a spot to repair.
Alright, last one.
Spot the right.
Yeah, usually weightlifting in general. Alright, who's coming over here for the last one? Who's the lucky star? Now it's you again. God damn it.
He's pretty motivated, I have to say.
Yeah. Even with all his downs, he's still trying. Never done a diving board before, gotta be honest. I mean, it's the idea of heights for this type of thing.
Yeah, I mean, that's fair.
I know the idea is perfectly safe, it's just I've never done it.
Nah, that's fair.
That's the only time a diving board is okay for these guys. Like, for one of these events, he was perfectly fine with it. He seemed happy with himself from jumping.
Yeah.
Okay, that appears to be everything. With a 73% succession.
That's not too bad for incident that you're supposed to play multiple checkers.
Yeah. So yeah, if any of you want to play this game, I'm not sure why you want to, but if you want to, get the Myth Savoy Nui version that's on the ModDB page, whatever. It's basically the whole game, you don't have to install anything, it's right there. Just go grab it if you intend to play this game ever again, because it's a much faster experience. Alright, so let me just go over here and then close the game, because we don't want music in the background. There we go. Screen goes weird. Right, that will do. So, let's just show the thumbnail, which is now pretty accurate, except for Kongu there with his red eyes.
Yeah.
I don't get that. Yep. Alright, so the next game we're doing, since I teased it would be a Sonic game, is Sonic and the Secret Rings, which, you ever want to play a game that has nothing but motion controls?
It's motion controls.
This was the peak of the Wii's release as a launch title, which means nothing but tilt controls.
God.
This is gonna be fun.
I'm going to feel bring out somebody just gonna be really frustrated. I'm just sorry for yourself. Yeah.
At least the game after Secret Rings, which was Sonic and the Black Knight, improved it so much by giving you an analog stick. This one does not. It's asking you to hold the Wii Remote sideways. Well, it was either going to be this or Sonic 06. Because they were going to port it for the Wii, but then they realized the Wii's not very strong of a console for a 360 game. We should probably change it. So they did. And we got this instead.
Okay, yeah.
Alright, so yeah, that's the next current main game we'll be doing. So, until Thursday, I believe. Today's Tuesday, right?
Yeah, this just is the first day.
Okay. Alright, well, till Thursday, we'll be doing Sonic and the Secret Rings. Until then, goodbye all.
Bye.